Blackstone Publishing presents Blastaway by Melissa Landers. This book is read by Kirby Heyborne and Lisa Flanagan. Chapter 1. Kyler Centaurus. It's not common knowledge or anything, but stealing a spaceship is way easier than it should be. So easy that an innocent kid could do it by accident. I would know. Because I was that kid. And it was an accident, mostly. It all started on my family's cruiser, the USS Whirlwind. We were on our way home from another trip to Nana's planet, taking the same boring route as always, the one without a single nebula or comet, or even any asteroids, to watch through the observatory. Just straight back to Earth in a pitch-black wormhole. Never mind that the Fasti Sun Festival was happening a short stop away. No, we couldn't spare a few extra days for a once-in-a-lifetime display of man-made stars. That would have been too educational for a family more interested in astroturf than astrophysics. But I'm getting off track. The day it all went down, my mom had her head buried in the gravity drive, tweaking the settings because that was what she did for a living as an engineer. On the other side of the pilot house, my dad was muttering funny non-swears like slime-sucking donkey lover at his tablet while he organized the next Anti-Niatrix Corporation protest, as in Quasar Niatrix, the planet flipper. Quasar's company fixed up worlds in other solar systems and sold property to people like my Nana, who couldn't afford to live on Earth because of the redonk taxes. Quasar was super rich with a billboard-worthy face and 11 dozen charities that helped folks settle on new planets. I imagine he was no saint, but I couldn't deny the man knew how to run a business. A lot of folks thought that was what Earth needed, to be run like a company instead of governed by the United Nations. I wasn't sure about that, but Quasar had offered to absorb Earth into his private corporation and pay every citizen dividends, as in free money. I guess my dad was allergic to cash because he'd been protesting for people to vote no on letting Quasar be the CEO of Earth. That was all my dad did anymore, come home from his nonprofit job and spend all night plotting Quasar's downfall. My father hated Quasar so much that his right eye twitched, actually twitched, every time he heard Quasar's name, which was a lot because the dude practically owned the galaxy. Anyway, my point is that my dad was too blinded by his rage-colored glasses to notice what my four brothers were about to do to me in the next room. Give me a norf, a noogie wedgie armpit fart. It's a thing, look it up. They added it to the slang dictionary. And, as usual, I didn't do anything to deserve it. I was minding my own business, kicked back on the sofa, watching a virtual reality simulation of the Fasti Sun Festival, because really, man-made stars, when a set of fists pounded on the door.
"Hey, open up, dork!"
shouted Duke, my oldest and jerkiest brother.
"Yeah, let us in!"
called another voice. It sounded like one of the twins, but I couldn't tell whether it was Devin or Rylan. Since they'd turned 14 and their voices had started cracking, they sounded exactly the same, like a moose in a blender.
"We need a fifth man for laser hockey."
"Well," added the other twin, "we need a man, but we'll settle for you, Kai."
A round of chuckles broke out. I heard my kid brother Bonner say, "Nice one!" "Butt kisser," I muttered under my breath. And to think Bonner used to look up to me. For a while there, he'd even copied the way I made my bunk every morning, tucking in the corners to create a tight, crisp edge. That was before he'd sprouted 4 inches over the summer and decided sports and girls were cooler than tidiness and science. Now that he'd joined forces with my other brothers, I had to look up to him. Literally, while he helped them terrorize me. At least I'd remembered to lock the living room door this time. With a sigh, I turned up the simulator volume.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.